Hi, it's Mary. Talk to me Tuesday. Tuesday, December 1st, 2020. I only have two things to show you again, and they're going to be no surprise at all. One of them is the monarch. Got two more blocks done. I'm up to two a week. That's okay, right? So I got these two blocks finished. They don't go next to each other, but getting there. I have, I think, 43 or 44 of them done now, out of 60, so, I'm just gonna keep making them. At some point, we're gonna have a finished butterfly. And then, when I'm paper piecing, I like to use, anytime I'm string piecing, I like to use, what do you call them? Leaders and enders? Something like, call them whatever you want. The little things that you use to, well, you know, I would go through a majillion pieces of fabric doing that, or I could use it for the greater good. So I always try to have another project that's kind of mindless, straight sewing, monotonous something to use as my leaders and enders. And what happens is, you know, you start on a block like this and you start on a quilt that's monotonous, repetitive, and for every one of these seams you have a seam there, and two blocks later you have a quilt. So I had this fabric hanging around. I had this poof fabric that I don't even know. I think I bought it on Etsy years ago, and I thought I had a yard of it, and I decided what to do with it. And then when I opened it up to start sewing, I realized I had 3 yards of it. So I have enough to make the backing of this. It's kind of Pooh and Tigger and Piglet. Nap time. Pooh, I guess. They all have their pillows and, you know, yawning and taking naps. And so anyway, it's cute. It looks like flannel because of the faded look to it, but it's not. It's just a good cotton. And then I had these two fabrics that happened to be sitting next to each other, and I thought they match. Had they not been next to each other, I wouldn't have realized that they match. I wouldn't have put those two together. Anyway, I designed, like, this has never been done before. This is just an 8-inch block with 2-inch strips, one on each side. And when you put them together, of course, you get a quilt. Well, I made it 5x5, which is with the 2 inches, it ends up 52 inches square, which is big for a baby quilt, but good for a little toddler nap time or something. So anyway, and like I said, I've got enough of the poo fabric to make, it won't fold for me. Oh well. I've got enough of the poo fabric to make the backing. So that's finished in between those two blocks, which puts me in the position of needing more leaders and enders. So I'm doing another quilt, and we'll see how many blocks it takes me to put that together. It's going to be a panel, so it's basically borders. It could be, I've got three fabrics that I bought a yard of each, and they're cute together. Had no idea what I was going to do with it. I thought I could make a 3-yard quilt if I was failed. But this one of the fabrics has a black in it, and this panel is black and white, and so I'm going to put some borders around it with these 3 yards and see where that goes. So that's going to be my leaders and enders as I plug along with that. And I can probably design that this afternoon because I went into work this morning and was there for 2 hours and I got sent home without pay. I don't know how long I'll be home. I have my file clerk tested positive for COVID and I was exposed. I don't think that I will test positive if I have it for 7 days. I last saw her either Thursday or Friday. I really, really think if I run out and get a test that it's going to be negative, and then I'm going to be back at work not knowing if I truly have it. So I'm going to wait on that. I don't know how long, a couple of days, and see how that goes. I do have a cough, and I was congested yesterday. I don't know what that is. I don't know if it's COVID. I'm coughing out of my chest, but I do that periodically. And so I don't know what's going on, but until I do, I am home without pay, which gives me time to design a panel quilt and continue doing that between my monarch blocks. So that's all I got for you. I'm gonna try to remember to post this one today because last week I recorded before I went to work and left it processing and then realized on, 5 or 6 days later, over the weekend, that I never finished it. So this one I'm going to do right now, and hopefully that'll be okay. And I am about to sneeze, which, I don't know, if I felt great, then I would probably go get tested and get back to work, but I'm congested and I do have a cough and it do kind of hurt right here, but it could be gone by tonight. I don't know. So anyway, I just don't think that a COVID test would give me a correct reading today. So I'll be home waiting and we'll see. In the meantime, quilt day. See you later. Have a good week. Bye.